Welcome to digisoundstudio.com and digisoundacademy.com. My name is Baba Prasad. In this video, I would like to show you Veena recording techniques. I want to show you the mic techniques for recording the acoustic Veena. Many people ask this question, should I use a pickup or should I use a mic in a stage or in a recording studio? Here in this video particularly, I'm going to show you three different mic sounds. I am so happy to have Mr. Shashank, who is a great Veena artist. He is a very lovely player. Actually, I like his tone. In this acoustic Veena, we have not attached any pickups. I'm going to show you the different mics here. If you have any questions, we can ask. We are using the SE Electronics, which is the dynamic mic. You can use a SM58, Shure SM58 or any dynamic mic. And I'm using the Rode NTG4 Plus Neumann TLM-102. Thank you, Mr. Shashank, for this wonderful playing.
Because it's always a perception of the artist through, you know, get the betterment of the sound and of its natural tone.
It's something similar to your acoustic guitar, because this is the place where you get the resonance, because there is an air hole there. There is also this minor carvings with small air holes. It's beautiful tone producing area, I can call it. And some people actually do a double miking technique, like from one mic here and one mic on the fret. So just to get the fret noise. Something similar to your guitar miking. I should get too much of the pluck noise, so I prefer keeping it there. So it is actually the individual's perspective. If you have two mics, if you have two input sound card, please just use it. And always you can choose which one is better. Pickups have a different tone, and it is actually to enhance the sound, because it has to compete with the percussion instruments. We might put him in the isolated room or something. I prefer keeping a mic and taking the natural tone of the Veena. If you don't have the facility to put the Veena artist in the isolated room, you can actually put just near the percussion or little far from the percussion instrument, so that you can go closed miking and then move the mics so near to the wooden body. If you are using a condenser mic, the room has to be treated fully, or else it's going to pick up a lot of unwanted frequency. The air holes, it might produce a little bit of this low-end resonance, we call it. It may be something similar to your blow sound which you have in your vocals. Please enjoy this sound. Let us know your comments in this video. Thank you for watching. Please click the subscribe button and click the bell button.